Welcome back to STS. In today's video, we're going to use the sum formula for a geometric series that's infinite. And we're going to use that or leverage that formula to help us convert a repeating decimal into its equivalent fraction. All right, let's begin by writing out the formula for the sum of an infinite geometric series. Here we have S, which stands for the sum, is equal to A sub 1, which is the first term in the series, divided by 1 minus r, where r is the common ratio. And the common ratio is just a number that's being multiplied by each term in the series. All right, let's take an example here of 0 and 2 repeating. Of course, that can be rewritten as 0 decimal point with a series of 2's after it. Of course, we can't show all the terms in this repeating decimal, or numbers in this repeating decimal, because it continues on infinitely. What we're going to do is leverage this formula. If we were to do that, we would take the first term. The first term would be seen as 0 and 2 tenths, plus the second term, which would be seen as 0 and 2 hundredths, plus the third term, which would be seen as 0 and 2 thousandths. And of course, I could continue this off infinitely. All right, if I were to add these up, and again, if this was done infinitely, we see that I have a series of 2's repeating. So we can say this here is the beginning portion of this repeating decimal. This first decimal, or this first term, is going to be seen as A sub 1, which can also be written as the fraction 2 tenths. This second term can be written as A sub 2, and that will be seen as 2 over 100. All right, so now we have some of the beginning portions of this formula. Well, A sub 1, we said, is 2 tenths over 1 minus r. Well, we need to figure out what r is. Again, r is the common ratio, and because we have the first two terms, r can be found by taking the second term and dividing it by the first term. In our example here, the first term is 2 tenths. So I'll put that as my denominator. And the second term is 2 one-hundredths, and I'm going to place that as my numerator. Here we have a complex fraction, and to solve a complex fraction, we take the top fraction, which represents the numerator, and multiply that by the reciprocal of the bottom fraction, which represents the denominator. The reciprocal just means to flip the fraction. Here I have 2 tenths, and that becomes 10 over 2. And before I multiply, I'm going to cross-cancel. I have common factors of 2 here, so 2 divided by 2 is 1. Again, 2 divided by 2 is 1. For these two factors here, I have a common factor of 10, so I can divide that by 10. 10 divided by 10 to give me 1, and then 100 divided by 10 to give me 10. At this point, I can multiply the numerators and denominators, so I end up with a value of 1/10. So this is the value of r. So I can come back to my sum of the geometric series formula and put in 1/10 in place of the r, and then now I can begin to simplify. I know that 1 is the same thing as 10/10, and I'm going to subtract that from 1/10. Again, I keep my numerator of 2/10, and now my denominator, I keep my denominator of 10, and I subtract the numerators, 10 minus 1 to give me 9. Again, I have a complex fraction, and I follow the same process where I keep the top fraction and I multiply by the reciprocal of the bottom fraction. Again, before I multiply, see, I can cross cancel. 10 divided by 10 is 1. And now I have 2 times 1 to give me 2, and 1 times 9 to give me 9. So here I'm showing that 2/9 is the same thing as 0 and 2 repeating. And the last thing I want to do is call up the calculator, just so that we can take a look at verifying the result. All right, with the calculator, here I've already put in the 2/9, and it gave me back 2/9, so I wanted to convert that 2/9 to a decimal. I did that by pressing the math button, and you see the second option is decimal. And when I did that, we see that I have a series of repeating 2's. So we can rest assured that 2/9 is the equivalent to the decimal 2's repeating. All right, that sums it up for this video by Spell Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the same name. And as always, thank you guys for watching.